Buenos días, Pastor Cristo, nuestros hermanos en Cristo. Esperamos que todos están bien, todos están sintiendo el amor de Cristo y de nuestras familias. Nosotros enviamos besos y abrazos a todas nuestras hermanas que son madres. Muchas gracias por todo el trabajo que ustedes hacen cada día, cada noche, siempre para nosotros. En este momento les queremos invitar que oremos juntamente para que el Señor bendiga este día especial y este servicio. Amén. Hermanos, así donde están de pie o sentados, vamos a levantar las manos y agradecerle al Señor Jesucristo porque Él es fiel. Amén. Señor Jesucristo, te damos toda la honra y la gloria porque tú eres Señor, nuestro Dios, nuestro Todopoderoso, nuestro Salvador. Señor, nunca podemos repagarte por, Señor, lo que tú hiciste en la cruz del Calvario, Señor. Nunca, Señor, podemos, Señor, no, nunca vamos a completamente, Señor, comprender, Señor, tu grandeza, tu fidelidad, tu amor, Señor, tu bondad, Señor. Tú eres, Señor, el todo para nosotros. Lord Jesus, we thank you for being so good and so wonderful because you have given it all for us. There is no one like you, and we thank you, Lord. We ask you that you bless this service. We ask that you bless every mother, Lord, and every family out there, Lord Jesus. We ask you to bless, Lord, those mothers that are sick in the hospital, those grandmothers that are sick in the hospital, wherever they are, Lord, that you would heal them and comfort them. Señor, oramos por todas las madres, Señor, que no se sienten, Señor, bien este día. Por todas las hermanas, Señor, que puede ser que están tristes o deprimidas, Señor, que ellas puedan sentir, Señor, tu amor. That all the moms in the world, Lord, and all the moms, especially, Lord, in the church, feel love, that they should know that you love them and that you are good. En el nombre de Señor Jesucristo oramos, amén. Hermanos, en este momento es una bendición, es un placer a presentar a estos hermosos niños, los nietos, la fe, ellos van a levantar una ofrenda de una canción y van a leer algunos versos. Dios les bendiga, hermanos. Nos vemos muy pronto. Amén.
Praise the Lord. I would like to wish all the mothers a happy Mother's Day. I would like to give thanks to God for my mom because she has been so wonderful to me.
Praise the Lord. Today we are going to recite Psalms 91. Psalm 91. In Jesus' name.
He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say to the Lord, He is my refuge, my fortress, my God, and in Him I will trust. Surely He shall deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the perilous pestilence. He shall cover you with His feathers, and under His wings you shall take refuge. His truth shall be your shield and buckler. You shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the pestilence that walks in darkness, nor the destruction that lives in the day. 1,000 before at your side, and 10,000 at your right hand, but they shall not come near you. Only with your eyes shall you look and see the reward of the wicked. Because you have been the Lord, who is my refuge, even the Most High, your dwelling place. No evil shall befall you, nor shall anything come near your dwelling. For he shall give his angels charge over you to keep you in all your ways. In their hands they shall bear you up, lest the giant should fall against a stone. You shall tread upon the lion and the cobra, the young lion and the serpent, you shall trample on your foot. Because he has set his love upon me, therefore I will deliver him. I will set him on high because he is my name. He shall call upon me and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life I will satisfy him and show him my salvation.
I will recite Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil, for you are with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. You prepare all the tables for the presence of my enemies, in the presence of my enemies, and you anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. Truly goodness and mercy shall follow me all days of my life. I shall dwell in comfort with her.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, today we're going to sing, Still I Will Trust You. Iglesia de Sion, paz de Cristo. En este día estamos celebrando la misericordia de Dios y también estamos alabando a Dios por todas las madrecitas que tenemos en esta hermosa iglesia. Y en este día deseamos, ¿verdad?, las madrecitas que, ¿verdad?, se reúnan con sus hijos, ¿verdad?, le den muchos besos a sus hijos, abrazos, y que sobre todo se regocijen en ser madres, como dice el Salmo 113, que la madre se goza en tener hijos. Al Señor sea la honra y la gloria. Hermanos, en este momento para mí es un alto privilegio introducir ante ustedes a mi esposa, la hermana Karen Maffei, que tiene palabras de elogio para todas las madrecitas de la iglesia de Sion. Nuestra hermana Cani Maffei. Amén.
Paz Cristo, hermanas. Les saluda con el gran nombre de Jesucristo y feliz Día de Madres. Quisiera darles un abrazo grande, pero como no puedo, pero muy pronto vamos a estar juntos en la iglesia y vamos a poder mirar uno y otro otra vez. Quería felicitar por este gran día de ser una madre. He estado mirando a mis nietos cantar a Dios y mis hijos sirviendo a Dios y conmigo en este tiempo, y me gocé de una manera tan grande. Yo sé que este tiempo de día de madre es muy diferente que las otras, donde podíamos salir con nuestras familias, pero hoy en tiempo tenemos que estar en casa. Pero durante estos tiempos en casa, podemos, como el verso, mi favorito verso, es el 94, donde se dice que como Dios nos cubre con sus plumas y bajo de sus alas. Con sus plumas y bajo de sus alas nos da protección. Nosotros como mamá somos el lugar, el amor, el corazón del lugar. Y queremos agarrar a nuestros hijos, protegerlos. Y todo el tiempo estamos oyendo de las nuevas lo que está pasando. Pero ten en mente que servimos un Dios grande que está con nosotros y que nos va a dar la fortaleza. Durante este tiempo, agarran a sus niños. Si son abuelos, si son tías, puede ser gran memoria en este tiempo con sus hijos en la casa. Podemos hacer gran momentos de oración, gran momentos nomás hablando con ellos, riendo con ellos y teniendo esa memoria en sus corazoncitos, porque somos mujeres de Dios. No tenemos que tener temor, porque nuestro gran Dios está con nosotros. Podemos enfrentar lo que viene porque Dios está con nosotros. Praise the Lord. I want to just greet my beautiful sisters in the name of Jesus. Happy Mother's Day. I know it's been a very difficult time these days, and at times we want to be grasped with anxiety and fear with all the things that we're listening to. But I want you to know that one of my favorite psalms is in 91, where it says we find ourselves under the wings and the protection of God. And how beautiful that we can be, know that we are protected. Oh, what a beautiful place to be under the wings of God. And that comfort, we as mothers give that comfort to our children. And the Word of God says that we are the closest thing to God's love. Although our husbands are the strength, we, the mothers, are the love. You know, it's difficult in these times. Yes, we're grasped with anxiety, but know that God is with us. We can make beautiful memories with our children at these times that we're enclosed. We have no place to go. Where do we go? We can't go shopping. We can't go to the malls. But yes, we can be at home and make memories for them. We can talk to them, pray with them, share stories about ourselves, and just, you know, just laugh and have fun with their children. These memories will follow them through the rest of their life. Know that we are women of God and we have so much to share with them. Don't lose this time with them. I just want you to know that this Mother's Day, like I said, the verse 91 gives me comfort. You know, The last words that I want to give you is that remember that you are clothed in dignity and strength, and you can laugh at the days to come. We can laugh because we know whose our strength is in. God is our strength. God is our power, and we're going to get through this. And once again, we're going to enter those doors of our church and be able to wave to each other and say, we've made it. Because God is with us and he is our strength. Happy Mother's Day. I give you a great big hug. And if I could, I'd give you that great big kiss that I'm used to in the cheek. But like times have changed, but all things work together for those that love him. And God has a plan in everything he's doing. God bless you again. Happy Mother's Day.
Amen. Dios bendiga mucho nuestra hermana Mafey por estas hermosas palabras que salieron de su corazón. Y nosotros deseamos, ¿verdad?, lo mejor para las madrecitas de la iglesia de Sion. Quiero dejarles un pensamiento en este día de las madres. Y se encuentra en el versículo que vamos a tomar, se encuentra en 1 Timoteo 2:4, que dice, el cual quiere que todos los hombres sean salvos y vengan al conocimiento de la verdad. Miramos en la palabra de Dios que Dios, lo que mueve el corazón de Dios es su amor. Y el amor, hermanos, es la fuerza motivadora que hace que Dios quiera o desee que todos los hombres sean salvos y vengan al conocimiento de la verdad. Y toda madre cristiana debe de tener lo mismo, sentir lo mismo, ¿verdad? Cada madre cristiana debe de tener esas dos metas de que sus hijos sean salvos y que conozcan la verdad. Antes de seguir adelante, quiero dar gracias a Dios por mi madre, la hermana Esther Mafey, por su dedicación, su celo por la obra de Dios y su apoyo al ministerio de mi padre, el hermano Leobardo Mafey Macías. Y también quiero decir que ella se distinguió en ser muy esforzada ayudando a mi padre económicamente, pues ella trabajó por fuera. Y también quiero dar gracias a Dios por mi esposa, la hermana Cani. Cuando yo la conocí, hermano, la hermana Cani era una jovencita. La conocí hace muchos años en un día de campestre del distrito de los jóvenes aquí en Hart Park, en Orange. Y la miré jugando voleibol con otra joven. Y dije yo, qué hermosa muchacha. Pero por la misericordia de Dios, ¿verdad? Nos casamos. Pero yo nunca me imaginé que esta jovencita llegara a ser una tan buena y excelente madre. Y quiero decir que lo que mis hijos son se debe a gran parte por lo que ella ha sido, o sea, por lo que su madre les ha dado. Y su madre siempre les ha dado palabras de afirmación. En otras palabras, cuando ellos venían a ella y dándole ideas y quiero hacer esto, quiero hacer aquello, mi esposa siempre les decía, mijo, mija, sí puedes, porque Dios está contigo. Entonces, en este día quiero honrar a mi esposa y también mi madre, ¿verdad?, por ser tan buenas madres, ¿verdad?, delante de Dios. Miramos en la palabra de Dios que el amor de una madre se asemeja al amor de Dios. Y el amor de Dios, hermanos, como decía hace rato, es lo que mueve a Dios y que desea, ¿verdad?, de que los hombres sean salvos y que venga el conocimiento de la verdad. Ahora, la madre cristiana, igual que Dios, debe de tener esas dos metas para sus hijos. Número uno, que sean salvos, y número dos, que conozca la palabra de Dios y la verdad. Miramos en la Biblia que había un joven llamado Timoteo. Timoteo, hermanos, llegó a ser un gran siervo de Dios. Y miramos el secreto de la vida de este muchacho, ¿verdad? Y Pablo hace mención en la segunda carta a Timoteo, en la cual Pablo dice que Timoteo había en él, lo habitaba en él, una fe no fingida. Pero enseguida él amplifica su expresión de la fe genuina cuando dice que esta fe no genuina primeramente había morado en su abuela Loida y en su madre Eunice. En otras palabras, Pablo reconoce que el joven ministro Timoteo era producto de los buenos principios espirituales fundamentados por su abuela y su madre. Eso es interesante. Loida y Eunice habían sido buenas maestras de la palabra de Dios, hermanos, y ellas le habían enseñado la verdad a Timoteo desde su niñez. Y primero es, por eso Pablo dice en 2 Timoteo 3:15, y que desde la niñez ha sabido las escrituras, las cuales te pueden hacer sabio para la salvación por la fe que es en Cristo Jesús. Ahora, en estos días, las madres cristianas, hermanas, ustedes han recibido el poder de Dios para moldear el carácter de los niños, de sus hijos, para el tiempo y para la eternidad. Cada madre tiene en sus manos la vida de sus niños. Y a través del buen ejemplo de las oraciones, de la enseñanza de la palabra de Dios, ustedes están moldeando la vida de sus niños para que algún día lleguen a ser unos Timoteos, unos grandes hombres de Dios. ¡Qué hermoso! ¡Qué privilegio! ¡Qué bendición es esto! Miramos, hermanos, que Timoteo llegó a ser un gran siervo de Dios por, como dije hace rato, por su abuela y su madre, que habían invertido bastante tiempo en él. En estos días, las madrecitas de Sion, en estos días que nos tienen, ¿verdad?, guardados en nuestras casas, es el tiempo apropiado, hermanas, para que ustedes, ¿verdad?, se reúnan con sus hijos, se recojan con sus hijos, abren la palabra de Dios y cuenten las historias bíblicas de la palabra de Dios, para que esta palabra se siembre en los corazones de ellos. Y esta palabra va a hacer efecto en ellos, les va a traer sabiduría, sobre todo les va a dar temor de Dios. Y ellos van a saber que la palabra de Dios los dirige, los guía para que ellos tomen buenas decisiones, ¿verdad? Y para cada madre, todos sus hijos son hermosos. Para cada mamá que yo he conocido, ¿verdad?, ella no tiene hijos feos. Ella tiene hijos hermosos y bonitos. Entonces, en esta mañana, en este día, hermanas, madrecita de Sion, les explico, ¿verdad?, que ustedes tienen la facultad y la oportunidad de que ellos primeramente se salven, pero que también sean útiles en la obra de Dios. Pero esto va a requerir de ustedes esfuerzo, sacrificio, perseverancia y constancia, hermanas, en la lectura y enseñanza de la palabra de Dios. Las sagradas escrituras harán de ellos, ¿verdad?, personas sabias, seguras y llenas del temor de Dios. Y por eso leemos en 1 Pedro 2:1 que dice: desead como niño recién nacido la leche espiritual no adulterada, para que por ella crezcáis para salvación. A esta hora voy a invitar a todas las madrecitas y a toda la iglesia que oremos por las madrecitas, para que Dios las bendiga, las proteja, las guarde, ¿verdad? Si algunas están enfermas, que Dios las sane, y sobre todo que ellas sean un buen ejemplo para sus hijos y que de sus labios siempre salgan palabras positivas y palabras afirmativas que van a ser de beneficio para sus hijos en el nombre de Cristo Jesús. Oremos, Señor Padre Celestial. En esta hora, Señor, te presento a todas las madrecitas de la hermosa iglesia de Sion. Yo te alabo, Señor, porque cada una de ellas es buena madre. Cada una de ellas desea lo mejor para sus hijos. Cada una de ellas desean que sus hijos lleguen a ser hombres y mujeres de Dios, sobre todo útiles, útiles en tu obra. Yo te pido, Señor, que a ella le dé la sabiduría para que de sus labios salgan palabras, Señor, guiadas, aleluya, por tu palabra. Bendice a mis hermanas, Señor, dales vida, dales salud, dales paz, dales gozo, dales tranquilidad, dales sosiego, aleluya, aleluya, que ella levante sus cabezas, aleluya, que ellas siempre te alaben, te adoren, te ensalcen, aleluya, especialmente algunas de ellas tienen hijos que se han apartado de tu camino. Ten misericordia de estos muchachos, de estos hijos, Señor, y regrésalos a tu camino santo. Te lo pedimos en este día, pero que en este día, aleluya, las madrecitas de esta hermosa iglesia, que se gocen en ser madres, que ellas se regocijen con sus hijos, aleluya, y que sean ejemplos para toda su familia, en el nombre de Cristo Jesús. Amén.
Hermanas, madres, paz de Cristo, es para mí un placer saludar a todos ustedes y nuestras oraciones son bendiciones y amor, que el Señor sigue usándolos en este ministerio poderoso que Él ha dado a ustedes y que Él cumple su voluntad en sus vidas. Praise the Lord, sisters. I just wanted to wish all of you, on behalf of myself and my family, my wife, happy Mother's Day. May God continue to just use you in that ministry, in that calling of being a mother. I'm thankful to God, amen, for my mom, who has been just a source of joy in my life. She has always been a counsel, a constant counsel and support and love in some of the most difficult times of my life. And I just want to say, Mom, I love you so very much. Happy Mother's Day. I'm also thankful to God for my wife, Carolina. She's so beautiful, and she lives her life reverently before God, and she lives just demonstrating her love, not only to myself, but to our kids. It's a 24/7 hour task, being a mother, and when I'm laying down in bed and I'm exhausted, she's still up. And she goes back, I want to say, two or three times to their beds just to make sure they're breathing. I have to remind her, Angel, they're not infants anymore. I think they're going to be okay. But she's persistent, amen. She's persistent in that love. Let's open up the Word of God today to the book of Exodus chapter 2. And we're also going to be reading from Hebrews 11. That's a chapter of faith. Hebrews 11, reading from verse 23. I received a word to my heart this week, and I wanted to just, in Jesus' name, share a little bit of what God has put in my heart. Exodus chapter 2, verse 1 and on, reads, "And a man of the house of Levi went out and took a wife, a daughter of Levi. So the woman conceived and bore a son, and she saw that he was a beautiful child. She hid him 3 months. But when she could no longer hide him, she took an ark of bulrushes for him, daubed it with asphalt and pitch, put the child in it, and laid it in the reeds by the river's bank." Hebrews 11:23 says, "By faith Moses, when he became of age, he refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter, choosing rather to suffer affliction with the people of God than to enjoy the passing pleasures of sin, esteeming the reproach of Christ greater riches than the treasures of Egypt, for he looked to the reward." What God has put in my heart today is when a mother acts in faith, when a mother acts in faith. Will you just bow your heads with me, lift up your hands. Lord Jesus, we come before you today. We give you praise and honor and glory as you open up your word, Lord. Hallelujah. Let your mouth, Lord, hallelujah, speak to every heart today. Oh, hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, may this word be a blessing. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, we just present this time. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We remember in the end of the book of Genesis that Joseph governed over Egypt. He was second in command, and the Israelites were brought there in the time of the famine, and they were nurtured and protected. This king was wicked and forced Israel into slavery, but he did not stop there. When he saw God's blessings over Israel, that they multiplied greatly, he set a decree against them. Every son that was to be born was to be thrown into the river Nile. But we know that God's eternal purpose can never be thwarted, no matter what man or what king in their plans. God's word always comes to pass. And it was during these dire circumstances that God used the faith of a mother not only to save her child, but also to save a nation. God's word says that her name was Jochebed. She was an Israelite, but she was a slave in Egypt, and she had just given birth. And the Bible says that her baby was a boy, and he was beautiful. We've all heard the pastor said that the one thing that you've never heard of before is a mama who thinks her baby is ugly. Amen. Every mom believes all of her heart. She knows that her baby is a gift from God and is just so beautiful. But while Pharaoh sentenced her son to death, Exodus tells us that she took it upon herself to defy the edict of Pharaoh. She didn't confide in her own strength, but she had faith in Almighty God. That's why she's mentioned in the Hall of Faith. The Hall of Faith in Hebrews 11. By faith, Moses, when he was born, was hidden 3 months by his parents because they saw he was a beautiful child and they were not afraid of the king's command. Moses' mother was not afraid. She was not in fear, no matter what Pharaoh tried to do, because she had her faith. She had her trust in someone that is so much more high, someone that is more powerful. Hallelujah, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, and the eternal God was on her side. And we can say, hear her saying, this Pharaoh wants to kill my baby boy. I'm not going to have that. I'm not going to allow that. And we can hear her quoting Romans 8. Hallelujah, if God is for us, Who can be against us? Not only did she believe in God, but she acted on her belief. Hallelujah. And that is what we call faith. Faith is when you believe in God, and that belief, it grows into trust, and that trust, hallelujah, that grows into obedience. That is faith. I believe that God is calling mothers everywhere to present your children to the living God. You're not going to allow the enemy to sentence your children to spiritual death, but you're going to call on the living God who is able to do all things. Jesus, I claim my child for you. In the powerful name of Jesus, I entrust my son. I entrust my daughter in, hallelujah, your hands. God is calling women to become prayer warriors, to become intercessors for the children. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And not only that, but begin to be bold, to begin to work with all that God has given you, to minister to your children. This mother was a slave. She didn't have very much. She had no one to turn to. Perhaps Pharaoh's soldiers were patrolling every corner, and she was doing her best to keep her infant baby, hallelujah, quiet and feed him through 3 months. But the Bible says she couldn't do it any longer. She couldn't hide him any longer. But she used what she had. She took an ark of bulrushes, which is papyrus seeds. She waterproofed it. Then she placed him in the reeds of the river Nile. And we remember the story, amen, who it was that later found him, Pharaoh's daughter, who also raised him later on. She did this all, hallelujah, all that she could. that she could possibly do, she did. But then she made a decision. She said, Lord, I am entrusting my son into your hands. God is calling on every mother today. Use what God has given you. Not only, hallelujah, on your knees. Not only in prayers. Hallelujah, but open up the word of the living God with your children. Teach them his word. Meditate on God's word. Memorize God's word with them. Train your children. The Bible says, train up a child in the way he should go. And when he is old, he will not depart from it. What does it mean to train? To train means to make fit, to make qualified, to form with instruction, to discipline, to prepare, to direct the growth of something, such as directing the growth of a plant, which is more than just watering and making sure it has enough sunlight. Sometimes that plant has to be bent straight up, hallelujah, so they can grow properly. Sometimes that plant needs pruning, and it might be that that plant will endure some pain and discipline, but in the end, that plant will be able to blossom beautifully. I praise God that God gave me not only loving parents and a loving mom, but parents that were really strict, amen, in a balanced way. I knew what my boundaries were. And I heard a pastor recently allude to this when he talked about boundaries for our children. And he tells a story of a little boy who lived in a particular neighborhood. And this boy was so little, he couldn't even ride a two-wheeled bike. He had a little tricycle, probably less than 5 years of age. And this little boy was riding around in circles. And a man was around, and a man asked him, son, what are you doing? And the little boy said, well, I'm trying to run away from home. And the man said, but son, you're riding around in little circles. And the little boy looks up and says, oh, but mommy said, I cannot cross the street. You see, even in this young age, this little boy knew what his limits were. Who set those limits? It was his parents. It was his mother. And I observe, amen, hallelujah, that. I have observed that in my life. And I praise God. To him be the honor and the glory. Another observation I have made is with my wife, as she has taken on the role with all of her heart in her role in ministry as a mother. And I thank God that sometimes I'm working and I'm going 100 miles an hour trying to complete a task, whether it be for ministry or for work. And I hear the house is really quiet, and it's very odd for the house to be quiet. Amen. When you have three kids, in 4 years, there's always a lot of joyful noise. Some of it's not always joyful, amen? But I hear the house gets really quiet, and so I walk down the hall, and I go into my kids' room, and sure enough, I see my wife kneeling down and holding our kids and just praying with them and just crying out to the living God. I believe that is the most powerful thing on earth, hallelujah, that we can do as parents and that you sisters can do, hallelujah, as mothers. To live for Christ, to hold on to our children's hands and gently pass their little hands into the one that made them, into the one that formed them, hallelujah, to the one that has a purpose and a plan. And the Bible says a good and perfect and pleasing will for their lives. How powerful is that? When we consider Jochebed, hallelujah, what she did and what resulted, hallelujah, that Moses, hallelujah, not only was saved because she put her faith on God, because she acted on faith, but she also, hallelujah, when Pharaoh was trying to kill her son because she trusted in God, God used that very enemy to be the one to give Moses a free ride, to be raised in his house, and to pay his own mother, Jochebed, to be a nurse for him. The Bible says that Moses was educated in all of the wisdom of the Egyptians. Hallelujah, advanced in science and math and medicine. The richest nation likely in that day. But that's not all. Hallelujah, that Jochebed's faith, that mother's faith, what it led to. She did more than that. She must have left more than a distant memory in her son's life and in her son's heart, because of the writer of Hebrew goes on to say, by faith, Moses, when he became of age, refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter. Whose son did he claim to be? Pharaoh's daughter? No. He claimed to be the son of Jochebed, the woman who risked everything, the woman who put her faith in Almighty God. That's why the writer of Hebrews says he chose to suffer affliction with the people of God than to enjoy the passing pleasures of sin, esteeming the reproach of Christ greater riches than the treasures in Egypt, for he looked to the reward. By faith he forsook Egypt, not fearing the wrath of the king, for he ensures as seeing him who is invisible. That faith that Jochebed had in Almighty God, now that faith was imparted to Moses, who learned to trust in the eternal God. And Moses' life was not only saved, the entire nation of Israel, hallelujah, was saved. And God's eternal purpose prevailed. God's promise would ultimately be fulfilled. That promise that was declared to Abraham when he told Abraham, "You will be a blessing, and in you all of the families of the earth shall be blessed." Today we share that blessing, the greatest blessing, which is the salvation that comes through faith in our Lord Jesus Christ. You, sisters, have the most powerful ministry, and you have the most powerful calling to be able to trust in God and to act in that faith, to live in that faith, and take up the hands of your children so that they can also walk in that, live in that, and receive the eternal promise that is given not only to us, but unto our children, to all who are far off, to all who the Lord our God shall call. Let's bow our heads. I just want to pray for you right there where you are, every sister, hallelujah, every friend that is listening to the word of God today. Just lift up your hands and close your eyes with me. Lord Jesus, I come before you today. I give you praise and honor and glory, for it is your Holy Spirit that speaks. It is your Holy Spirit that comforts. It is your Holy Spirit that gives each and every one of us to act out in faith, to act out in love, to cherish, hallelujah, hallelujah, to show affection, to have patience and kindness and gentleness. I pray, Lord, an outpouring of your Holy Spirit upon every single mother that's listening to this word today, upon every young lady who will become a mother in Jesus' name one day. Oh Lord, that you would give them the strength, that you would give them the courage to keep on moving forward, to not get tired on their knees, to not get tired in the word, and to begin to live out and act out in the faith and in the ministry that you have called them to. In the powerful name of Jesus, we pray. Amen, amen. And let's give the Lord his praise. Hallelujah. He is the one that deserves all of the honor and all of the glory.
Hello again. It's wonderful to be in the presence of God and hearing his word. We're so blessed to hear such wonderful messages from our pastor and, of course, Assistant Pastor Brother Leo Maffei. Hermanos, es una bendición una vez más escuchar las palabras de nuestros hermanos Pastor Leobardo y hermano Asistente Leo Maffei, amén. Hermanos, este día es un día muy especial, entonces vamos a seguir exaltando el nombre del Señor Jesucristo. Y yo estaba pensando, hermano, que uno sabe que es bendecido cuando puede decir con convicción que ha tenido la mejor madre y también se ha casado con la mejor esposa y la esposa también le sirve al Señor con todo el corazón. I believe it's a wonderful privilege and a beautiful blessing. I think every one that is blessed is able to say, you know what, I believe my mom's the best mom and my wife is, I married the best wife, who's also an amazing mom and who is an incredible mom, right? So we've got two mothers that we think are the best in the world, and I think that they should feel that way today. So give your mom, if your mom doesn't feel comfortable with it, then give her, you know, give her a wave with a blow of a kiss. If you can give her a hug, you feel safe doing so. Man, what kind of times we're living? You can give your mom a hug sometimes, right? I mean, that's a crime, right? Anyways, give your mom a hug and kiss safely. Please do so safely. But if you are not seeing your mom, go visit her virtually or on FaceTime, whatever you can do. But tell your mom that she's special. Amen. So a couple announcements. Hermanos, algunos anuncios de parte de nuestro pastor. Una vez más, te damos las gracias. Apreciamos muchísimo su apoyo. Es algo tremendo ver en el programa Venmo que muchos hermanos están dando los diezmos. Y yo me siento parte de un equipo, hermano, cuando veo algunos de ustedes dando de esa manera. I feel like I'm part of a team, and I think it's wonderful that I see you guys giving on Venmo. And I say, that's my church right there, Sion Casa de Oración. It's beautiful seeing that. So please continue to give whatever God has put in your heart to give. Hermanos, vamos a seguir dando la calidad que el Señor pone en nuestros corazones. Número dos, hermanos, el pastor quiere agradecer a los hermanos que han sido parte de la cadena de oración. Para mí es una de las cosas más tremendas que nosotros hemos hecho para ver el sacrificio, para ver el amor, la pasión que uno ha mostrado en estos tiempos. Es algo hermoso, hermanos. Yo quiero agradecer a los jóvenes que ayudaron también anoche y esta mañana orando por una hora cada uno. Thank you so much to young people who set an hour aside of their time last night and into the morning. It was beautiful and awesome. You guys were raising your hands. Some of you guys were saying, whatever time you need me to pray, just to put me on for that time. That was beautiful. You know who you are. I appreciate you. Some of you guys prayed for the first time last night. Let's keep it going. Hermanos, una otra cosa. El pastor está pidiendo que cada hermano que está en buena salud, que cada hermano puede, que cada hermano, si puede, que ayude con la con el ayuno, hermano. Una vez a la semana, hay tanta necesidad que nosotros, yo creo que a veces debemos ayunar dos veces a la semana, pero por lo mínimo una vez esta semana. Young people, if you can go ahead and continue to fast one day a week, that would be wonderful as well. If you don't have something to fast for in your life, you can fast for me and my family. You can fast for the pastor. You can fast for whatever need God puts in your heart. And we want to continue having a family altar. Hermanos, vamos a continuar teniendo un altar familiar. Para mí, no hay nada más hermoso, hermanos, de orar con mi esposa. Y hay veces que nosotros no podemos orar por una hora entera con la esposa, con la familia. Pero si nosotros oramos 20, una media hora, es algo poderoso, algo tremendo que se siente, hermano, uno con el otro, con la esposa, con nuestra, para mí, mi mejor amiga, pues la que hace todo, ¿verdad? Que cocina, que limpia, que ora con nosotros. Es algo hermoso poder orar con nuestras esposas. So go ahead and continue to pray as a family, pray with your wife, pray with your husbands, and let's begin to make it a habit, not just in these times, but we should do this hopefully for the rest of our lives, pray with our family once a week. Until next week, that's going to do it for us today. We love you guys. We appreciate you. Once again, thank you so much to our team behind the scenes, Caleb and Natalie, the amazing duo. Go ahead and give them a round of applause virtually or here too. You guys rock. We appreciate you guys. We love you so much, church. Hopefully we see you again soon. We got to see you guys soon. Okay, God bless you. Have a wonderful Mother's Day. See you soon in Jesus' name.